everybody, this is Bunkhouse Bob.
And the lovely Mark.
Live from the Armory Wrestling Show is heard worldwide. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time on Blog Talk Radio. But this is an FNX.network plug, which means we're heard from Mobile, Alabama to Melbourne, Australia. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Check us out on FNX.network. What do you say, Laura?
From the Armory Wrestling Show, the premier podcast of indie wrestling.
You're lying, Bob. I never said I don't want to do this interview. Those words
never came out
of my mouth. You are the biggest lying sack of crap ever.
Our studio line is area code 213-816-1605. With your host, Bunkhouse Bob.
Yes, Laura almost got lost in her home state of West Virginia, but she's with us tonight. How are you, Laura?
And the lovely Laura.
Foot is about to sign your ass as a home state if you keep that shit up.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Live from the Armory Wrestling Show. My name is the Bunkhouse Bob, and I am the greatest wrestling mind of the 21st century. Folks, this is episode 296 of the program. Not many more left in the tank for old Bunkhouse and the lovely Laura. But coming up tonight, folks, we have packed up the wagon. We have put on our Sunday best because, ladies and gentlemen, we're heading to Burke County, and we're going to revisit the Heroes of $5 Wrestling coming up here in just a little bit. Big Donnie, Terry Houston, Jeff the Hitman Hart, the current reigning, defending, undisputed $5 heavyweight wrestling champion, and Lil Donnie will be on the show with us tonight. Folks, thank you very much for tuning in wherever you're listening at, however you listen to the program, whether you're just now checking us out or you've been with us for the whole ride. We appreciate your support, and we appreciate you going over to www.fnx.network and checking out all the great content that's available on FNX. Everything from the world of anime, entertainment, news, television, sports. If you are a soccer fan, you want to make sure that you check out fnx.network. Make sure that you're going over there and giving them your support. Speaking of support, we would ask that you would go over to www.prowrestlingtees.com, type in FNX Network up in the search bar. There's a couple of Live from the Armory Wrestling Show shirts that you can purchase and help support the final legs of this show. Put the last $3 in the tank for us. That would be awesome. And I would also, I almost forgot about this. I forgot about this last week. Make sure that you go over to Facebook and type in, go into the search bar there, and type in Positive Pins. That's P-A-W-S-I-T-I-V-E, Pins, P-I-N-S. Check out Penny, our good friend Penny, and all the stuff that's going on with Positive Pins. Huge supporter of Penny. She's got a lot on her plate coming up and could use all the positive energy and support that we can provide her on this program, and I know that you can provide her too. So make sure you're checking out Positive Pins. And last but not least, if you have a question, a comment, a critique, or a criticism about a guest or a commentary that you have heard on this program, you can always email us at asktheArmory@gmail.com. And because Mr. Coles just loves this song, I've got to play a little bit more of it because I didn't play it last week. It's, I don't know, the unofficial, official theme song of Live from the Armory Wrestling Show here in 2020 as we skid in to our final episodes. I want to welcome to the show my co-host, our co-host, the only co-host that matters, the lovely Laura. Laura, how are you tonight?
It's the final countdown.
It is the final countdown. You know, I was looking. This is episode 296. After we get done with this one, there's only four episodes left. After that, we're on the downhill slope. The lovely strands of Europe. Do what? Yes. Oh, I'm going to turn it off because I've heard enough of it. But I had to play it because this was George's theme song at his senior prom. There, we've got enough of the final countdown. How are you tonight?
I'm doing good. I asked you, I don't think you heard me. I was asking you, where's your mullet?
Oh, I didn't hear you, and I'm growing it right now. It's growing as we speak. Hey, I had a sweet mullet in like 87.
Well, you know, I think everybody had a mullet. Girls had mullets, too.
And that's true.
And there's still some walking around Galax, Virginia with mullets.
Johnny Smalls is walking around with a mullet in 2020.
No, Johnny, I was getting ready to talk about Smalls, but Johnny Smalls is not walking around with a mullet. Don't mention mullet to Johnny Smalls because he just posted today on Facebook that if he ever becomes president, first thing he's doing is outlawing mullets.
Oh, that's terrible. Why would you outlaw such a popular hairstyle?
Bob, now come on. Those hairstyles are horrible. Absolutely horrible.
You know, a lot of people, and I don't talk a lot of political stuff on this show, but a lot of people want to blame global warming on several different factors. You know, the industrial infrastructure in China, you know, the warming of the seas because of pollution and dumping there. What has caused global warming is all of the Aquanet that was sprayed between like 83 and 88, 89-ish. That is what depleted the ozone layer, and that is why we have global warming. It's an Aquanet epidemic.
It is. I have to admit that I was part of that.
How many cans of Aquanet did you go through in a week?
Oh my, probably two.
Wow. And those were the big cans, right? I mean, we're talking, these were like they had like the huge, huge cans.
Is it? I didn't use only Aquanet. I used a little product called Finalnet. And that shit was like liquid glue.
Like fast freeze.
It really was, because that Finalnet came in a pump. It came in a spray bottle. It was not aerosol.
Okay.
And I can still hear that. Boy, you knew your hair was not, and my hair, it wasn't going anywhere. The top of my head. No.
See what you get, folks. You never know what you're going to get on an episode of our show. You know, we're here supposed to be talking about professional wrestling, and we're talking about Aquanet, fast freeze, and mullets, and it's, I don't know, it's like Ferris Bueller's Day Off. It's Bunkhouse Bob's Day Off. 2020 is what it is.
You start shaking up baby, I'm out.
Oh my God.
Twist and shout, rather, not shake it up baby, but
good times, good memories. Speaking of good times, won't you go on and give out the social media, and we'll dive into Mr. Coles' Twitter poll of the week, because we got a big show lined up tonight.
I say that George Coles just messaged me and said that his prom theme was actually "I Will Always Love You," the Whitney Houston version. My junior prom theme was "Something to Believe In" by Poison.
Oh boy!
So yeah, so just want to let you know, little tidbit there. While I'm looking up on the Twitter machine here, went to my junior prom by myself.
I'm trying to remember.
I was determined to go, so I went by myself. I had a date my senior prom, but not my junior.
I think our junior prom, I think our theme was Whiskey Bent and Hellbound by Hank Williams Jr. I think. Can't remember.
Oh, God.
A long time ago. Carry on.
So our social media shtick is George Dolly Parton Whitney Houston Coles is on the Twitter machine tonight at From the Armory. You can follow along with me, Bob, George, and our good friend Dr. Googletron at Circle Sky, at Bob underscore Dell, at Heel Heat, and at The Gray Lobster, all respectively. You can find us on Facebook at our official page and also our fan page. You can also find us on YouTube, where the episodes for the last 4 years are uploaded onto YouTube. So if you're out trying to make your town and maybe you want to hear what Steve Carino was saying back before he was a WWE employee. And by the way, Bob, I gave him that number.
Oh, you did? Okay. All right.
I just want to make sure that I did give him that number. Which reminds me, here in about 4 minutes, I have to text him and remind him. Lord have mercy. Anyway, we got a great this is going to be good. George had a great idea for a Twitter poll.
Mm-hmm.
Where would you like to see at Anthony Henry sign? And of course, his Twitter handle is not Anthony Henry. It's like Anthony Henry. And we had WWE, New Japan / ROH, AEW, or Stay Independent, which I'm really surprised by these poll results that AEW and Stay Independent tied for first place at both 40%.
Okay.
And then New Japan and Ring of Honor at 20%, and WWE at 0%.
Okay.
I myself would like to see Anthony Henry, just my opinion personally. I'd like to see him in Ring of Honor. I think, here's the thing. I don't think he would be a bad addition to Impact X Division, if they still even have an X Division, because I don't even watch the product, but... I think he would be a great addition to that.
Let's set the plate here for a minute, because I want to make sure I've got my facts right. Anthony Henry's contract with Evolve had expired. He opted not to renew with Evolve. I believe they wanted him to stay and to continue on. This on the heels of some interesting material that came out courtesy of David Starr, about the way that some Evolve stars were being paid or not being paid on appearances for WWE via Evolve. There was some, there were some shenanigans going on that were made to light. And not saying that this is what Anthony, the basis for him not re-signing with Evolve, just giving you some backstory. The thing with Anthony is that the guy is incredibly talented. That's a no-brainer. If anybody's been watching Anthony over the past few years, especially at his time in Evolve, you can see that the guy is absolutely tremendous in the ring. And I think what has happened with all of these other promotions that have came about is that it's opened the gateway where a person may not necessarily want to stick it out, just hoping that they're going to catch a break. Because if I'm not mistaken, Anthony has already had a tryout with the WWE, and he's been on WWE programming. But the Evolve thing, I don't know if it's the right fit for him. I'm tending to agree with the poll. I don't necessarily know if AEW is a good look. Perhaps it could be, because he has obviously veteran ring experience. He has television experience, pay-per-view experience, which is something that AEW is seriously needing. People with that type of experience to help those that do not have it, help them along. I'm tending to agree with you. I think that Impact might be a good look for him, given their schedule and what they're allowing other individuals to do, continuing to wrestle for other areas. AEW is allowing the same thing. The ROH, you know, New Japan deal, New Japan would probably require him to go to the dojo, either in LA or in Japan, for an unspecified period of time. And you don't know what's going to, once you sign that, that's an exclusive deal. There is no hopping around. Same thing with Ring of Honor. I don't know. I'd like to see him keep his options open. I'm thinking AEW or Impact, but either any place that Anthony decides to go is a plus for that person that is signing him. Anthony Henry is that good of a talent. That good of a talent. So thank you very much, Mr. Coles, for your Twitter poll this week. What did you see this week? Was there anything that caught your eye in particular?
I don't know. I've talked to John about this, but I don't think I've mentioned it on the show. I don't know if anyone is checking out the shoot interviews with Black Bart on YouTube, but there's some good stuff on there. I met Black Bart at WrestleCade last year. Or was it the Gathering? It might have been the Gathering. Sometimes all that kind of runs together. But anyway, great guy. Absolutely a great guy. He was so animated and so fun. And his shoot interviews, I had forgotten that he was the last world-class championship wrestling heavyweight champion. I forgot all about that.
Okay.
And he talks about working with the Von Erichs. He wrestled Kerry Von Erich in Kerry's last wrestling match.
In world class or
in ever?
Before? Oh, ever. Okay.
I believe that's true. I believe that is true. Because like Bart said, he had Kerry's last wrestling match ever. And
okay.
He had Kerry in a cage. He beat Kerry in a cage.
Really?
So, I mean, he's got some good stuff about the time he was in the Carolinas. And John, he's never been to Roanoke because I told him he'd scare the crap out of me. It was WrestleCade. I met Black Bart. And he said, "Where at?" And I said, "Roanoke, Virginia." And he said, "I've never been to Roanoke, Virginia." And I'm like,
I have not. I've not seen those. I'll have to check that out. I've not seen them.
You certainly need to. He talks about being good friends with Bruiser Brody. He was there when David Von Erich died in Japan. He talks about working in the Carolinas. He talks about working in Florida. It's some good stuff from another perspective, who, you know, is different. You know, because he was a little bit of a journeyman. He would go to territories. You know, different territories. And wrestle and, you know, have a little bit of a different perspective. Definitely check him out. They're little bitty pieces. He'll talk about, you know, he does not care for Jerry Lawler. He talks about, it's just really, really good. He's at home and it's really laid back and it's relaxed. And I really and truly highly recommend you check those out.
I'm going to have to, because I'd like to find out the timeline on that match with him and Kerry, whether it was his last match in world class before he went to the WWF, because I'm trying to remember how this worked. Kerry gets signed by the WWF, goes to the WWF, and then comes back to world class?
I'm thinking it may have been because didn't he get fired for... Black Bart was talking about, you know, he said the man, you know, wrestled with, you know, without a foot. You know, right. Mark did mention that. You know,
yes.
He wrestled without the foot. So, yeah, I'm thinking, you know.
I'll have to look into that.
Yeah, you have to look that up. Or look, and those are really incredibly good. You know, maybe it was the Texas. I think it was a Texas Indy after World Class. It might have been George. Maybe he's blurred the timelines, but, you know, he was talking about being World Class champion, and so I kind of, you know, assumed he was at the time. But mm-hmm. he had to have been, if not the last, he had to have been, like, one of the last World Class champions.
Okay.
Just because of the timeline. But, yeah, so... good stuff. I highly recommend it. I fell asleep during Raw. Did not get to mm-hmm. see any of Raw.
Mm-hmm.
So because I came home Monday evening with the worst headache known to man, and went to sleep.
Okay.
So woke up and kind of was out of it. Also, too, I don't know if you've seen an interview, and I'm not sure how old it is, but. Enzo Amore had it on his Instagram. It was an interview that Fox did with him and Big Cass. And I'm thinking it had to have been before Big Cass had this last kind of incident.
Mm-hmm.
But it's really good. You know, you should watch that too. I was, you know, I'm a big Enzo and Cass fan. You know that. But check that out too. It was interesting to hear them both talk and to hear Enzo talk like a normal human being. Not that he's not a normal human being, but you know what I mean.
I know what you mean. Other than that shtick. And I haven't heard anything out of Big Cass since that last meltdown either. Haven't heard a peep.
Yeah, I'm hoping it's getting no news.
Hope so too. Anything else that caught your eye?
No, I think that's kind of it. You know, Bob, I'm kind of, you know, screeching to a halt where wrestling is concerned. We'll be going to wrestling in Ivanhoe at the last of the month. AIWF is having a wrestling show there. But other than that, yeah, I'm kind of like, you know, slowly but surely, you know, waving goodbye.
Mm-hmm. A couple of things I saw this week. Ken Shamrock. His father passed away. I saw that on Twitter after an extended illness. Okay. Certainly want to send out our condolences to the Shamrock family over that loss. Always a difficult time. The other thing, one of the other things that I saw this week is the explosion on social media, on Twitter, especially about the pictures that Paige had posted. And it just it never ceases to amaze me. It's obvious, and I commented on it on social media. It's obvious that that Paige has had some type of enhancement, plastic surgery, work done, whatever you want to call it, whatever you choose to call it. You know, and of course, there was the endless parade of morons that got on, you know, Twitter talking about, you know, how she's, I don't know, scarred herself for life, you know, from, you know, the time that she was, you know, 19 till now, and just a whole bunch. What's that?
Mind your own damn business.
Mind your own business. Yeah, it's like, I don't know. Yeah, it's, her mom had some, Sarah Knight had some interesting comments that I won't repeat, but yeah, it just never ceases to amaze me how somebody can sit there and post a picture of themselves sitting on the floor with their dog, and you know, all of a sudden it becomes, you know, the hot topic, you know, to trend, you know, for the next day or two. Yeah, you know, just nothing but negativity. I mean, people can't be happy for people. You know, I mean, if there was something about, let me put it to you like this. If there was something about yourself you would like to change, what would it be and how would you go about changing it? I mean, that's a pretty fair question. You know, for some people, it's a hairstyle. It's their style of clothes. It's, I don't know, maybe they go out and buy, you know, white strips to put on their teeth to make their teeth whiter. You know, everybody always, you know, most people, I don't say everybody, most people are always changing something about themselves. You know, what's the difference with this young lady changing her appearance, and whether she does it through surgery or diet or exercise or whatever it is? You know, it doesn't matter. It's her life. You can't live your life through her. And that's what a lot of people are doing on social media, living other people's lives through osmosis, I guess. I don't know.
Again, my own damn business.
Something on a more positive note. Former show guest Aja Pereira has signed with the WWE, and it was announced today that she will be the first African-American female referee for the WWE. So I want to send out huge congratulations to Super Aja Pereira, the Princess of Pizza. I think that's a pretty good moniker. Everything she talks about is pizza power. Very nice young lady, and certainly want to wish her all the best of luck in her journey with the WWE. We'll be watching you, Aja. Good luck. Good luck and congratulations. The last thing that I wanted to mention, did you watch the Super Bowl at all, Laura?
I did. Something that struck me as odd,
and I just wanted to get your opinion on it real quick before we get the $5 guys on. Was it just me, or did it seem like there was an empowering message, not so much hidden, about women throughout the entire Super Bowl, from the beginning, you know, the pre-show, through the game itself, through the commercials, through the halftime show, through the commentary? Did you feel like there was something going on that maybe people didn't catch?
I think a lot of people got hung up on the whole Super Bowl halftime show. And, you know, here's the thing, people, is people were having a fit about their kids seeing that. And I hate to tell you, you can't see worse than that. I guarantee it.
Hey, I'm gonna go one step further. Listen to this, folks. Let me tell you something. Okay? If Shakira and J Lo want to put on a halftime performance in my backyard and dance and sing, I'll be sitting out there every damn night. Every night.
Exactly. And you know, what they had on was, I didn't see anything wrong with what they had on. You know, I don't have children, so I don't have that perspective of, oh my God, I can't believe they were doing all that in front of me. You know, someone had posted these photos of what people wear on Dancing with the Stars. J-Lo and Shakira had more clothing on than what these people. You don't give me that bull crap. I, you know, if you didn't like it, fine, whatever. I'm not here to change your mind. I didn't have a problem. You know, perhaps Karen, you ought to go, you know, get you a cold drink at that point in time. I don't know, but I had no problem with it. And it was awfully empowering. And J-Lo had, and this is another thing that just, J-Lo had this big flag, and it was the Puerto Rican flag. And I saw a lot of people on social media, why she got the Texas flag? It's not the Texas flag, you dumbass.
Mm-hmm.
It's the Puerto Rican flag. Because she's Puerto Rican.
I don't know. I thought it was interesting. I just thought it was interesting. And it just caught my attention. So, all right, we've come down to the time of the show where we're going to bring our guests on, and these gentlemen are no strangers to Live from the Armory Wrestling Show. They've been around with us for quite a number of years. And Laura and I were, at the beginning of the year, we were debating about, you know, who do we want to have on? And both Laura and I automatically agreed 100%. That we had to have some incarnation, some variation of guys that had worked or worked for $5 wrestling, because some of our fondest memories, like I put in the tagline, and our funniest moments have come courtesy of our good friends at $5 wrestling. So I'm going to bring these guys on. And I'm going to start down here, and I'm going to welcome to the program, if I've got this right. This should be Big Donnie. Are you there, Donnie? Donnie, can you hear me?
Hello?
Yep, Donnie, can
Donnie!
You hear me?
Hey, how are you?
Okay, we're good, we're good. So there's Donnie. We're going to bring on the next one. This one should be our good friend, Hardcore Terry Houston. Terry, are you there?
I'm here. That's me.
All right, good man, good man. Present and accounted for. And last because he, well, not last because we're still waiting. Little Donnie isn't with you, is he, Big Donnie?
No, but I think Numbnuts is trying to call me. So
okay, all right. So we're going
to
go on and bring.
Out how to use the phone.
He can, yeah. I figured as much. So bring this guy on next because he asked for a special introduction, and because of certain accolades, he does deserve them, ladies
oh,
and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Coming
the Canadian
to you,
redneck.
Yes, the Canadian redneck, but we got to be nicer than that. He asked to be called Mr. Two Belts. He is the current reigning, defending, undisputed $5 heavyweight wrestling champion. We'd like to welcome to the program the Beast, Mr. Jeff the Hitman Hart. Jeff, are you there, sir?
Yes, sir. Canadian redneck. Big
Donnie. Yeah, I didn't. Yeah. I think Donnie said it. Terry said it, I think. I don't know.
Who the hell said that? Damn.
I know. We can't. We're not going to.
Hey, I said
not,
it. I said it. You know it's true.
Yeah. All right.
Ditto.
All right. Ditto. Yeah. Guys, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for taking time out and being on the program with us. You know that we really appreciate your time.
No problem, man. Anytime.
No problem.
All right. Good.
Always good to be on.
Yeah, it is. It's good to hear you. I haven't seen you since November. As we're waiting for little Donnie to get on, we'll go on and I guess we're going to go on and get started with simply doing this. You know, like we did the last time, we kind of went round table. That way everybody got their opportunity to talk. So I just wanted to ask you guys how you're all feeling mentally, physically. How's everything going? Donnie, we'll start with you.
I'm doing good. Doing good. Just been working, staying busy, wrestling pretty much every weekend.
You've been working out. I mean, you last time we saw you, you've lost a lot of weight.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to stay pretty active.
You're still carrying it on.
Still heading in the right direction.
Good. I'm glad to hear it. Terry, how are you, man? Haven't talked to you in a minute. How you been?
My man, I'm just old.
You're just old?
Yeah.
Old and tired.
What's that? Retired.
I said old and tired. Are you unretired? Because you did retire and now you're unretired.
Man, I guess the game needed me or something. Hell, I got more bookings the 2 months after that than I did the year before that.
All right. Now I see this other caller popped up here, and I'm going to presume that this is Little Donnie. So I'm going to check this real quick. Little Donnie, is that you?
He's on the
phone.
Yeah,
Numbnuts has arrived.
Yes, little Donnie is with us. Little Donnie, how are you tonight?
Good.
Numbnuts, that quarter in the payphone is going to run out before the end of the conversation.
Oh boy.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Donnie
he
wanted
made
to,
it
little,
to it. Yeah. That's
yeah. Bad yeah. Little Donnie, we wanted to say thank you for taking time out to be with us. And how are you doing tonight, man? How you feel?
Doing good. Looking forward to what Jeff Hart fast this coming Saturday.
Yeah. Well, we're getting ready. We'll talk about that. But I wanted to go on, and because he is the $5 champ, and he is carrying the company on his back right now. Jeff, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. Yeah. And I got booking for Friday night and Saturday night.
Yeah.
Friday night, I'm in Tracy Smyrna Benefit.
Okay. That's pretty cool.
And Saturday night, I'm somewhere in the North Carolina mountain area.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I noticed that you.
What the hell did he say?
I'm not sure. I noticed that you.
Donnie, what the hell you said, redneck?
Well, Numbnut said he was going to be beating up Jeff Hart, but I thought they were the Canadian Outlaw mud show workers or whatever.
Yes.
I need Drawing you, Burke County, Chicago Bear, Wingjet can't win a Super Bowl.
Oh, here it comes. Here it comes. Now we're down to name calling.
Y'all win a Super Bowl is 1905.
1905 is when the Bears were in the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
86.
86.
Yeah.
86, whatever that is.
Now, I know that Laura had a very specific question that
I
she
did.
Wanted to ask Little Donnie. So this is specifically for Little Donnie.
Donnie and I had a great conversation at dinner after WrestleCade Super Show. He had me in stitches. So I was wondering, what were you thinking when parties were just passing their kids off to you to watch?
Passing kids off to watch.
Hardy actually gave you his kids to hold. I'm like,
he's been hitting the head.
Hey, Jeff Hardy loves Little Donnie. And Brian Pillman's son loves Little Donnie too.
Yeah. That'd be Brian Pillman Jr.
Yeah, he added me to Facebook last night, told me he's going to be glad to work me in the Battle Royale this weekend.
Yes. Okay.
Well, guess what? I'm going to whoop his ass too.
I hope he gets
your hook too, Jeff.
I hope he throws your ass over the top.
No, I'm one of the last ones. Me
nuts?
And Jeff both is.
Mm-hmm. What? What? You're acting like it's fixed. You're acting like it's fixed. It's a matter of law. It's your pro wrestling lock, Pete.
I'm not throwing him out.
You know what you're going to do.
Exactly. Timeout.
They have got Jeff slinging his son out.
They got what?
They got Jeff slinging Brian Brown's son out.
Hey, the next time I'm telling Fritz to put you on a different loop.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so.
I'm getting slung out by Tracy's mothers.
Okay, well. Thanks for giving away the entire match to us, Little Donnie. We appreciate it. Now we know who you're getting eliminated by.
I guarantee you none of that will happen.
Probably not. So much for kayfabe.
You can sit in a car and experience that for 6 hours.
I don't think I can take it. I really don't think I could bear it.
We put him in a trunk. We put him in a trunk one time.
Yeah. Exactly.
We put him in a trunk one time, and he still talked all the way to Alabama.
And guess what? I'm going to be a daddy now.
You do
oh
what?
Oh, my God.
He really ain't.
You're going to be a daddy.
He really is. You got sick today.
All right, hold on. Everybody. Everybody just calm down for a second. I want to make sure that I got this right. Little Donnie.
Yes.
Did you just say
yes.
that you're going to be a daddy?
Yes, I found out today.
You found out today?
Yes,
well,
she got checked today and it came good.
She got checked today and it came, the rabbit died, so you're going to be a dad.
That's right.
Well, that means
you screwed a rabbit.
No, it doesn't mean you screwed a rabbit, Jeff.
Did he say wabbit? You
yes, he
fucker.
Said wabbit. Oh, my God.
Poor
Jeff
kid.
Red Rock said he was your daddy.
Oh my God.
Poor kid.
Well, I guess we should say congratulations then, little Donnie, on the announcement of how do you feel about becoming a dad?
Oh God.
Oh God. That's what I said too when my wife told me.
Oh God, and he ain't gonna know what to do.
Yeah.
Nah.
All right, so
that kid's gonna need a lot of help.
He's got all of you guys.
That kid's gonna have daddy issues.
All right. So did you get the answer that you wanted, Laura? I guess Jeff Hardy loves little Donnie, and babies love little Donnie. You're going to go with that? Okay. All right. So this is what we're going to do, guys. We came up because the theme has been five. I've got five questions or five topics that I want to throw at you, time allowing. And what we'll do is we'll go like what we said. We'd go round robin style. You know, we would speak to each of you. Okay. So the first topic or the first question is, what do you think the legacy of $5 wrestling is? And we'll go on and start with Big Donnie. Big Donnie, to you, what does that mean?
I think it was something that I think it was first meant for, you know, just laughs and, you know, people to, you know, have fun and enjoy, you know, just enjoy the show. It wasn't anything like, didn't look like there was being a lot put into the show. And, you know, starting out, but then as the company, you know, went on, it's like our booking was a lot more than you see in WWE. And it's like we really, I mean, they didn't have all the, you know, people wasn't putting all the input in it, but it's like our product is, a lot more people was enjoying watching it. And I think you know, people have been able to live their dream, Freight Train getting to wrestle and everybody, you know, getting to know Freight Train around the world and, you know, getting to know the kind of guy he is, and you know, getting to see, you know, like you get some new guys coming in, and then you get the, you know, the guys that have been in the business a long time that are still being seen around $5, and I don't know. I'm glad that $5 started back up.
Terry, for you, what do you think the legacy of $5 wrestling is?
Donnie pretty much hit it on the head. You know, it's about a bunch of guys that are trying just to do good, you know, for the goodness of the business. The last handful of shows we did, the atmosphere in Hebron Hall has just been amazing with, the outpouring support of the fans. And, I mean, it's just got a totally different feel than every other place I've been. And, you know, that says a lot by, you know, the fans showing their thanks for what we're doing, you know. And, yeah, and like Donnie said, you know, it started out as, you know, not being so glamorous and, you know, whatever. But as it's evolved, I think people's taking it more and more serious as they're seeing, you know, the bigger names come around and, you know, some guys joining in throughout the years. And, you know, it's really like a cult now, you know, and it's fairly awesome.
Little Donnie, for you, I mean, going all the way back to the Heroes of Burke County and all that, what does $5 wrestling mean to you?
It means a lot. Yes, I did some stupid shit to get into $5 and stuff. I agreed to that.
Hey, did you ever get that blade open?
I should have never cut my hair in front of the camera, but
yeah,
it's got me places I've probably never been.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair enough.
$5 is a good place. It's it's grown a lot. And I am happy that Gentleman James is my tag team partner now.
Jeff, good tag match working up.
And I think $5 is going to get much better.
Okay. Jeff, for you, a lot of people see you as the face of the company right now. What do you think $5 wrestling legacy is?
Like Big Donnie said and Terry said, but start out slow, you know, and grow up. I mean, a lot of people coming in, brand new people, all that stuff, you know. And Frank May made the company, but now I'm the face of the company now, getting more cheer. I mean, people cheering me on. I'm supposed to be a bad guy, but I done beat the living hell out of Joy Janela, but I got my ass whooped.
Yeah.
I still want my rematch against Joy Janela. And I heard Kenny Omega is a big fan of mine.
Yeah. Well, we're going to get into that Joey Janela match here in just a little bit.
All right.
The next question I had, and Donnie, you kind of alluded to it at the beginning. A lot of people, when $5 wrestling first came on the scene, looked at it, not laughed with it, but laughed at it. And my question for you is, did the hate ever get to you, or the criticism ever get to you, or was it exactly what you said? I hear Gorilla Monsoon's voice in my head, the boyhood dream had become reality. Did it ever bother you?
That's to me?
Yes, that's to you. It's going to be to everybody. We'll start with you first.
I caught a lot of flack over the Heroes of Burke County DVD, because a lot of the guys, a lot of the veterans in the business around North Carolina and South Carolina were blasting it. And they were threatening to, we're going to come, hurt, Lil Donnie and this and that, going to beat the crap out of him. And then some of the guys came up and realized, they're like, hey, wait a minute, that's Donnie's little brother. They're like, he used to, go around shows with me when he was young.
Mm-hmm.
And, they're like, then all of a sudden they didn't want to do anything. It's like, I had to defend those guys. But, as Jake has talked to about in the past, I had a problem with that DVD at first, because I'm a veteran of the business. I think of it that way, and I wasn't very happy about the blading right in front of the camera, and I was pretty upset at it. But it's like I talked to George, and me and George House talked a good bit about it. He's like, Donnie gives these guys a chance to be seen and get to do something in the business where they probably wouldn't even get a chance. And he's like, these kids are getting watched. And, they may be getting some, bad publicity about it or whatever. He's like, but they're being watched. And he's like, these guys are getting a chance. And then Things started, going a little better. I started seeing and agreeing, more with George, and then getting, just getting to see Freight Train, and actually seeing what Train's overcome, and getting to live his dream, and it runs back into getting to see numb up get better, and some of the other guys get better. And you can tell that, although they weren't supposed to really have a shot and people were knocking them, these people are wanting to watch the $5 guy more than they are them.
Hmm. Okay.
So it's good to see it grow.
And like I said, I myself, you know, I didn't wrestle on the Heroes of Burke County. It was after that was taped when I was recovering from brain tumor surgery.
Right.
So, I mean, I didn't wrestle on it. I kind of, you know, made my way back, and eventually came in later on. But like I said, I tried to defend the guys and stood by them instead of, like, just knocking them like everybody was doing for a while.
Right, hanging them out to dry, that kind of thing.
Yes.
Terry, for you, did the criticism, not so much about, you know, Heroes of Burke County, but just being associated with $5 wrestling, did the criticism ever bother you?
Not so much. Not really the criticism per se. I guess it was everybody's not knowing attitude. You know, it was, you know, not being on the inside, knowing what we knew, that it was there for, you know, Train and, you know, some of the select other few, and they were still thinking that, you know, they were trying to exploit them and make a fun of them.
Right.
And I battled it, you know, and now it seems like everybody wants to get booked on the show, you know, so evidently we did it justice and brought it around.
That makes sense. Freight Train, we've had him on this program, very personable. And I think when people started to hear his story and saw the documentary of him getting to travel overseas, it opened up a lot of people's eyes. For you, Lil Donnie, did the hate ever bother you?
Some of it did, but after my brother talked to me and stuff, and after I got in an argument with Oscar and stuff like that, it was just that Oscar was hating because I was getting more chairs than he would ever get in the business. And
that makes sense. Jealousy,
yeah,
plays a factor in it.
I love fodder wrestling, and fodder wrestling's it's a good company. There's some good workers there. My brother's a good worker. Terry's a good worker. I love working with the older guys that's been in the business, where they paved the way for the new guys.
Okay.
But what if it weren't for the older guys, they would not be any new guys.
That's true. That is true. They did pave the way. Jeff,
and
you.
Over the years, I got the shit bit out of me to learn. You respect a veteran, or you get the shit smacked out of you.
Yeah, and that's true. You do have to show the respect. That is true.
He's always had a hard time listening.
Well, the school of hard knocks is always open for business.
Thus, he continues to get slapped.
Yeah, so that's why it's still open to this day. Jeff, for you, you've taken a lot of criticism online. Even before the Joey Janela match and even afterwards, does the criticism ever bother you?
No, I don't care a damn about them, what they say about me, but it's what it is. I just ignore it.
Yeah. Well, that's a good attitude.
They got something to say, they get set in my face and want to talk behind my back.
Right.
You're not a man.
Okay. I just received a message too, Jeff. I've got a call here, and they asked to speak specifically with you, and I don't recognize this number, so we're going to go on and roll with it. 803, you're on with Live from the Armory Wrestling Show, and the guys from $5 Wrestling. Who is this?
It's Kavina.
I haven't heard from you in a year or 2 years. How are you, dear?
I'm just fine now that I get to talk to Jeff Hart.
Jeff Hart. Jeff, do you remember Kavina?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now,
hi,
Kavina.
Oh.
Jeff,
I've
do you remember Kavina? You've never seen her before.
I do.
Well,
I've never seen her before. Talked to her on your podcast.
Yes. Well, I know that Valentine's Day is not that far away. February 14th is Valentine's Day. Kavina, did you have a special Valentine's message for Jeff Hart?
I do, Jeff. I was wondering, would you be my Valentine?
I'm sorry. I've got a girlfriend, lady.
What? Oh.
What? You have a girlfriend?
Yes, I do.
Oh.
I love her better than anybody.
Jeff, I don't know what to say.
But I'll meet you in person if you available Friday night.
Available Friday in Tennessee. What happened to the girlfriend?
Hey, it's got a girlfriend, but if you're available Friday night, his girlfriend might not be there.
My girlfriend won't be in Tennessee. She's going to be in Virginia.
In Virginia. Oh, okay. All right. Well,
a bit of Ric Flair still runs all over all of us.
Yeah, I know. Space Mountain is all around.
Sevierville, Tennessee, next to, let's see, Pigeon Forge.
Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, Kavina.
Big Donnie's available.
Little Donnie.
Little Donnie, yes, yes.
Terry Hicks is available.
I've already got two women. That's enough.
15 minutes before the sound. I'm going to stop crying. I'm going to shoot.
Oh,
that's 14 minutes and 58 seconds too long.
I can go all day long.
I say 14:59 too long.
Oh my gosh. Oh my God.
I go 24/7 and 48 hours all day long.
Okay.
Jeff, the good thing is you won't have to worry about missing the bell. You'll be there, buddy.
Kavina, thank you so much for calling in. And Jeff says he'll meet you in Sevierville or Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, Friday night.
Bye, my love. I'll see you Friday night.
All right. Thank you, Kavina.
Au revoir.
Au revoir. Yes, au revoir. I don't think she was French, but okay. Let's see here. Let's get back to the matter at hand. I've lost my train of thought. Okay. Want to talk about the Jeff Hart, Joey Janela match. And I want to talk, first of all, I want to talk to you, Jeff, about it. Because this isn't the first time that a bigger, we'll say a more well-known named star, Joey from CZW. A lot of people are familiar with his work. He's now currently with AEW. Comes in and wants to work with Jeff Hart, reminiscent of Cliff Compton coming in working with Donnie. What are your thoughts now, looking back over the match, Jeff? What do you think that match did for your career?
I make a name of myself, but when Joey kicked my ass real good, and I'll whoop his ass, but everybody know what I got, and my name's out there now, you know.
Yeah.
What Jeff can do. Joey said, I belong Ring of Honor or TNA, Impact, NXT, whatever.
Wherever.
I belong. Or yeah. AEW or New Japan. I don't care.
Yeah.
I take anybody.
Okay. Well, how was Joey to work with? Was he stiff?
He's not stiff. He's light, you know. But he's very hardcore. The table didn't break, you know. It takes four times to put me in the table, but it didn't break. But
so
he got something to break it with.
Yeah.
And
so the table was stiffer than Joey?
I mean, he did everything to me to break the table, but the table won't. The table won't break. I mean, you know, it still keep on going on. I said, "Damn, when that table gonna break?"
Yeah, but it finally did. But,
I mean, I learned from him, and I listened to him, and he's a good wrestler. I mean, I respect him. Totally respect him.
That's fair.
And
that's fair.
I still want my rematch against him, and he accept my rematch.
Okay.
But,
well, we'll put that out on Twitter and see if we can get a response from Joey. Was there something that Joey said to you after the match that you'd care to share? Did he give you any words of advice or encouragement?
Yeah, I forgot what he said.
Oh, okay.
He said something. I don't remember what he said. I didn't. Big Johnny would know.
Okay. Well, that's what I was going to get to. You know, Donnie, I mentioned, you know, Cliff Compton coming in, working with you. Really put a spotlight on $5. What did Joey Janela coming in working with Jeff Hart do for $5 wrestling?
He basically, Joey, honestly, it's like Joey acted like he'd been a member of the locker room the whole time $5 been around. Stood around, talked with us. He was like one of the guys. Interacting with all of us. Sitting and hearing. He'd always been a big Fodder fan. He'd always get the DVDs and stuff from Caleb, and whenever seen High Spots, and he always kept. Up with it, that's always what he wanted to do, when being the AEW was starting up, and having a job there and actually putting it out there that he was coming to fight our wrestling, it actually put the company out there and got more publicity, but. Also, since that match, since Jeff won the belt, he's actually brought up Fodder Wrestling again on Twitter, and he's like, I've seen somewhere that I'd like to go back to that, hey, I could go back and get a title shot now for my rematch. The company over. Joey's a good dude. I like him.
Very cool.
There's one request I want to mention. I want to wrestle Kenny Omega. One-on-one. That's it.
You want to wrestle Kenny Omega?
Yeah, he's a big fan of mine, but I want to wrestle him one-on-one. That's it. That's my green match right there. One-on-one.
Jake Manny? Are you there, Jake Manny?
Now, Jeff, does Kenny? Are you and Kenny friends on Facebook?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Does he follow you on Twitter?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Well, why don't you just direct message him and tell him, say, Kenny, I'm ready.
I will do that if he listens.
Well, that'd be a big help if he listened.
Well, he's from Canada, so maybe he'll understand half of it.
What?
He
might not understand the redneck part, but he might somehow get the Canadian part out. Yeah.
Yeah, he might. We're going to go on and. I want to go on to the last question that I want to talk about, because Jeff just mentioned it. There's a road trip coming up, and I want to make sure we get that in. I want to know from each one of you, and we'll start off with Donnie. What do you think, Donnie, is the future of $5 wrestling?
I think we got a great crew. And I just see bigger and better things. I see I think there will be other people, you know, coming in and continuing to want to do something without our wrestling, because like I said, you know, I hear more and more, it seems like rather often I hear, all the guys in WWE, these other companies that have always enjoyed, just sitting back watching the shows and just enjoying themselves. And actually, pro wrestling giving them a reason to smile, because a lot of the stuff WWE puts out it puts me asleep. I can't, it dang sure don't put a smile on my face.
I understand. Terry Houston, you have retired more times than Terry Funk, but now you're active again. What do you think the future of $5 wrestling is? What would you like to see happen?
I don't know. I think we're headed in the right direction with, getting bigger name talent and coming in working with the core group of guys that we have. And, we've basically got a home now here, locally in Charlotte, where we don't have to travel 6, 7, 8 hours up the road for a show a couple times a year.
Right.
So that's a big plus too. And, it's just, just continuing the name and pushing the young guys and getting their faces out and getting other veterans in and working with their younger guys. I mean, here again, that's what it's all about is, molding these young guys and giving it to them once, guys like Donnie and myself leave.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. One of those younger guys, Little Donnie, what do you want to see happen with $5 wrestling? Because there's going to be a point in time where you're going to be one of those veterans in the $5 locker room. What do you want to see happen?
I want to see $5 to make bigger steps. Like, I would love to see $5 pit Vince out of the business, but I wish somebody would pit Vince out of business since he don't know how to run a business.
You want $5 wrestling to put the WWE out of business? Yeah,
exactly. $5 is going to grow a lot more.
Oh, my Lord.
I'm looking forward to the tag matches that's coming up that Jake's talked to me about.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to boost it up a lot.
Yeah.
Make $5 a lot better.
Okay. Fair enough.
I'll make sure to tell Jake not to book a battle royal.
Hey, battle royal pays your money, hey. You got to take what you can get.
It could be a tent.
But if you're giving away the finish, everybody knows the match.
Yeah, Little Donnie.
There's 9 big names in that battle royale tomorrow night, and I ain't giving none of them away. They're still with companies.
The finish. You told us everybody just throwing everybody out.
Well, the next thing you know, it's going to be a $10,000 battle royal, and Little Donnie's going to let everybody know that there's really not $10,000 involved, and then I'm going to be pissed. So,
Brian Pillman Jr., if you're listening, please kick numbnuts of the balls for me.
I'll take it. I'll kick him
on the ball Friday
balls.
Night.
Jeff Hart, you are... You are the $5 wrestling heavyweight champion. What do you want to see happen with $5 wrestling? What do you want to see happen? You're the face of the company. You are the champ that runs the camp right now. What do you want to see happen?
I like to see like former WWE superstar, like American Giant or Jake the Snake Barber or Devin Delafay to come in.
Yeah.
And work with the young people,
Right.
But It maybe won't happen, but I know the American Giant going to be there 18th. Jimmy the Snake, whoever he
yeah.
is.
Jimmy the Snake.
But I like to see Brandon Fisher for $5 wrestling continue go face to face, you know, like Charlotte, North Carolina, Jeffersonville, Indiana. I want them to come to Tennessee, the New Jersey, New Orleans.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or
okay.
Any other state.
Right. Now you want it to be a traveling show, correct?
Right.
Okay. Now I have heard this date, February 18th, and I keep hearing Jeffersonville, Indiana? Is that am
yeah,
I correct
at
on
the
that?
Arena.
Okay. Donnie, I think that you or Terry probably have the most information on this, so what do you guys know? What's going on with $5 here in Indiana?
I don't know any matches to put out there, but it's Jeffersonville, Indiana, at the arena, February 18th. So, you know, if you want to come out and check out $5 Wrestling, it should be a pretty good show. Like I said, I don't know any of the matches right off. I don't know any of the matches. I know Jimmy the Snake's there, Paradigm, Freight Train, all the usual, all the regular $5 guys, and plus some other guys that are from Indiana. I think Big Country, several of the guys that know Pondo and work for Pondo in Indiana.
How about that midget that bit you on the ass last time we were up there?
Dude, I fucking remember that.
There.
Hey, if that happens, I'm not gonna catch the steps on the way out. If somebody throws me over, Jamie, don't tell nobody.
Yeah,
who's gonna be there?
Oh my lord.
He said he was coming from round two, Dory.
Oh my gosh. Okay. All right. Well, guys, we want to really, really thank you. Both Laura and I want to thank you. From the bottom of our heart for allowing us into your world and allowing us into your lives, both inside the ring and outside the ring, because we've met several of you in person, you know, Donnie and Terry, and have, you know, really grown a friendship out of professional wrestling. And it's all because of you guys allowing us into your world. So for me,
we appreciate it.
It is the boyhood dream become reality. And you guys will always have a special place in my heart. No matter what anybody says about you or what anybody says about $5 wrestling, you guys really are my heroes. So just wanted to let you guys know that from the bottom of my heart and for Laura. We both really, really appreciate you guys doing what you do and allowing us to be a part of that.
You're welcome, and I myself want to thank you and Laura for all y'all have done for independent wrestling, helping you getting a lot of the guys on the podcast, and some people that are just starting out, and giving them a platform to get their name out there. So I appreciate all y'all have done.
You're welcome. You're welcome. It's been our pleasure. Pleasure.
I can't say thanks enough either. You know, we were there probably one of the first, handful of shows, like third or fourth show, maybe something like that.
Yeah.
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 And we've been around for the ride, and you know, I appreciate everything y'all did, and you know, getting the younger guys seen and giving them a platform to get their name out there. And like I said, you know, before, that's what it's all about. You know, these young guys, you know, they come into the business and, you know, they're just dealt a handful of cards and they have to play them, you know. And it's guys like you and guys like us that help play their card, you know. And that's what it's all about.
Yeah, awesome, awesome. So, I want to thank you guys again. It's been a real blast to have you on. Little Donnie, thank you so much. Jeff Hart,
you're welcome.
Big Donnie, Terry
Mom,
Houston.
You welcome.
Yeah. Sir?
I'm very happy. I mean, talk to you tonight and listen to your podcast. You and Lori are great. Y'all going to be missed of all of my heart. I love y'all.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you very much.
Don't stop coming to shows and watching us.
Oh, no. No, we'll never stop. We'll always be around somewhere, little Donnie. You can best rest assured on that. Gentlemen, again, thank you so much. We appreciate you. Love you. And y'all take care, okay?
I love y'all.
All right.
See you guys later.
We'll see y'all soon.
Bye.
All right. See you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. There goes all of our good friends at $5 Wrestling, and Laura and I will be back after this brief message.
Hey everybody, Bunkhouse Bob.
And the lovely Laura.
Folks, we've been telling you for the last 5 years.
5 years.
All the different ways that you can listen to Live from the Armory Wrestling Show. You can hear us on www.fnx.net, where you can hear us on Blog Talk Radio, iTunes, Stitcher, YouTube, blah, 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 blah. The most important thing is, do you listen? Every Wednesday night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, Live from the Armory Wrestling Show.
Don't miss it.
Oh, my. What a great time. Talking with the guys from $5 Wrestling. You never know what you're going to get, and I'm happy with that, because what it is that they are the most down to earth, real people doing what they enjoy to do, and that's entertaining other people. Whether sometimes it's at the expense of themselves or the expense of other people, especially little Donnie, as you could hear for yourself, absolutely awesome, absolutely tremendous, really, really, really meant what I said, and I know that you meant it too. Love those guys so much.
It wouldn't be WrestleCade without Donnie being there.
Absolutely. It's a highlight getting to see Donnie every year.
It is. I haven't seen Terry in a long time. I haven't seen Lil Donnie, and I haven't seen Jeff Hart either. I'm really glad that Jake started $5 Wrestling back up, and that they're going back up into Indiana, because they had some really good success there. Before they, those were the first $5 Wrestling shows were up north. They were not, in Charlotte.
Correct.
Rumble in a Rec Center. That's a good one. And Donnie, little Donnie didn't give away the ending.
Giving away the finish. I gotta love it. And that, and Brian Pillman's son. Yeah, Brian Pillman Jr. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I don't know. Here's the thing is that, and I have to give out, a huge shout out to Jake Manning, Colt Cabana, Marty DeRosa. For continuing on the $5 legacy shows, the $5, the tradition and the legacy of $5 wrestling. There is a person that I think that needs a special shout out, and that's absolutely is Freight Train. There are so many moments and things that you can point to that, is historic moments in wrestling, and in $5 wrestling. And I really think the Freight Train documentary opened a lot of people's eyes, that, like what Donnie had said, where people had felt like that Jake was taking advantage of Freight Train, that it was all a ploy for, revenue or money or whatever. And honestly, Freight Train better than what I do. And just speaking with him, he's the most honest human being I've ever met in my life.
He really is. And he's so sweet. Oh.
This is a guy that just wanted to wrestle. These
mm-hmm.
are guys
well,
that just wanted to wrestle. Right.
Yeah.
These
and,
are guys that just
know,
want to wrestle and entertain people. That's all.
And there's a place for them. I mean, you know, we've said before, you know, wrestling has a lot of niche kind of things. You've got death matches. You've got people who only watch women's wrestling. You've got
right.
the $5 crew. You've got Lucha Libre, you know. The list goes on and on and on. And there's just room. There is room for everyone in wrestling. And, you know, I always think back to us going to dinner that night with Freight Train and Don.
Yeah.
We ate in that little hole in the wall that's not there in Winston-Salem any longer.
Right.
And you know, just having a wonder. I will tell this again. This is the funniest story ever. It is at a PDX show. I get in early, and Freight Train's sitting down. I go over and talk to him, and I'm like, you know, Train, are you thirsty? You want me to get you water? Yeah, get me water. And so I run over and get him a water, and I get back, and he's talking to Moose.
Yeah.
And Moose is like, yeah, you know, I've only been in the business a couple years. And Freight Train goes, that's all right. You'll get better.
I love that story. I love that story.
I had to leave. I gave
yeah.
Freight Train his water, and I had to leave because I was about to roll in the floor. The look, I can close my eyes and see the look on Moose's face to this day. Oh, my God. It was just like, yeah, you just got put in your place really quick.
Here's the thing, too, is that, you know, we've touted and patted Nick Aldis on the back for putting the NWA on his back and keeping the lights on in the joint, patting him on the back for interweaving modern-day themes and stories into a traditional program. And if you go back and look at any of Freight Train's promos, Nick Aldis has been stealing his material because Freight Train will reference modern-day social events and social media into his promos to the point where Jake Manning has to cover his mouth because he's laughing because
yeah.
he knows what he's saying. Other people aren't catching it, but Freight Train knows exactly
yep.
what he's trying to say. And it's awesome. It's absolutely awesome. So,
and we love you, Train.
Absolutely. And I've got a picture. I'm going to have to find that picture of that dinner with me and you and Donnie and Freight Train and Boy Band. And I'm sitting at that table. I've got a picture of all of us somewhere
yeah,
in my pictures. I will have to put that on social media. Certainly want to thank Terry, Little Donnie, Big Donnie, and Jeff Hart again for coming on the show tonight. We had an awesome time with them, as I knew that we would. Certainly hope that you guys found it entertaining, got a laugh out of it, because that's what we intended to do, and I think we did that. So want to thank them again. Coming up next week, because we're counting this down, next week will be episode 297. And the guys that are going to be on next week, one of them, I've not met one of them. The other one I'm very familiar with. Started talking with each other on social media and all that other stuff. And he's got a very interesting story. This is a guy that's taken wrestling fandom and worked it in with some friends of ours with a little company called Top Rope Belts, and has positioned himself to know some very prominent people within the wrestling business. And he does a lot of great work in promoting professional wrestling, promoting Top Rope Belts, doing work for charity. We're definitely going to talk about that because I think that's a side of this person that people have not seen. Next week on this show, we're going to have Mr. Jay-Z Flair and his co-host, because they've just started a podcast, Mr. Paulie B will be joining us next week. And we'll talk about being the Bojangles champion. We're going to talk about Top Rope Belts. We're going to talk about getting involved with getting involved with Conrad Thompson and getting involved with all different kinds of things within professional wrestling.
The first time I ever met Jay-Z, I didn't really know who he was. He looked at me and said, "You look so much better without Bob Dell." And I said, "I like this fella." And
that sounds exactly like something he would say.
Was super great to me and John when we were at the Tony Schiavone and Conrad comedy show, at the Comedy Zone. The What Happened When live in Charlotte, just super great, and he is absolutely, and I can't wait to talk to him. I've got a little challenge for him that I'm not going to reveal until next week. It's going to be on.
Like, very cool. Don't keep
talking. But real quick, Bob, I do want to say something. You did not know this person. I only knew her because I had met her one time at the last NWA Legends Fan Fest in Charlotte. But John knew her because John had been going to Fan Fest forever, and she was a an institution at these. And I missed her at WrestleCade. I don't know how I missed her, but I was informed today that Miss Patsy passed away. She was such an, I only met her one time, but she was such a sweet and nice lady. She, had a lot of friends. I've seen a lot of posts on Facebook, a lot of people, Vicki Roberts, who helped George South out. They were good friends. Patsy, unfortunately, I'm trying to figure, what is her last name? She just passed away not too long ago. Emily. I cannot find her last name. She had just passed away not too long ago either. And she was a staple in the wrestling in Charlotte. And I think she'd done some work with AML as well. So two good people we've lost in the short time span. I just want to give our condolences to Patsy's family.
Absolutely.
Like I said, I know you didn't know her, but she was a really sweet person. And I could tell that, she definitely meant a lot to a lot of people. And just wanted to, mention that.
Absolutely. Folks, we thank you for listening to this episode of Live from the Armory Wrestling Show. Whether you listen to us live on Blog Talk Radio or heard us on any other major podcast platform known to mankind, including FNX.network, we'll be back here next Wednesday night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Until then, have a good week, be kind to one another, and remember, there's never a bad seat here at the Armory. Thanks for listening. We'll talk soon.
Have been listening to Live from the Armory Wrestling Show, the premier podcast of indie wrestling. Listen to us on blogtalkradio.com every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Subscribe to us on iTunes. Follow us on Twitter at From the Armory. We're also streamed worldwide on www.fnx.network, and we're also available on Stitcher. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/live.armory.9. If you like what you hear, please take a few moments to give us a 5-star rating on iTunes. Thank you for listening. See you next week.